ভদ্ৰা এছ একাডেমীলৈ আপোনালোক সকলোকে স্বাগতম জনাইছোঁ। আশা কৰিছোঁ আপোনালোকৰ প্ৰিপেৰেশ্যন বহুত ভালদৰে চলি আছে আৰু আপোনালোকে আমাৰ এই মক টেষ্ট ছিৰিজত এনৰোলমেণ্ট কৰি পেলাই আপোনালোকে নিজকে টেষ্ট কৰিব পাৰে। তো আমি ভদ্ৰা এছ একাডেমীৰ ফালৰ পৰা আপোনালোকৰ কাৰণে এখন চেম্পল মক টেষ্ট পেপাৰ আপোনালোকৰ আগত প্ৰেজেণ্ট কৰিছোঁ। আশা কৰিছোঁ এই মক টেষ্ট পেপাৰখনে আপোনালোক সকলোকে লাভান্বিত কৰিব।
So the answer of this question will be the C, that is third only. Okay, so let's go to the next question. Consider the following statement on asteroids and meteors. The first statement about the meteors and asteroid is the small pieces of rock which move around the sun are found in the orbit of the sun and earth are called asteroids. Second, the small pieces of rocks which move around the sun are called meteoroids. Third, meteoroids may come near the earth and tend to drop up on it, and due to friction with the air they get heated up and burn, which is absolutely correct, right? Second is absolutely correct. The small pieces of rock which move around the sun are called meteoroids. Maybe sun, maybe another planet, they can move anywhere, right? They have the kinetic force, they can move, and universe do not have friction. So they move and the speed what they achieve while they started moving. So the second and third option is correct. So the first option is totally wrong. So the answer should be the B. The next question is, consider the following statement about the gravitational force. About the gravitational force. The first is, the gravitational force is same at different latitude of the Earth's surface. This question has been, like, similar question has been asked in many, like, 2-3 years back in UPSC. So I put it this question in a different way. So try to solve it. Answer is given, no problem, but you need to have an explanation. The gravitational force is same at the different latitude on the surface. It is greater near the equator and less at the poles. Gravitational force of moon is greater than of earth. All right. The first question, the first statement, the gravitational force is same at different latitude of the Earth's surface is totally wrong. No, not at all. Let me tell you, gravitational force is the weakest at equator. As you will increase the latitude, the gravitational will start increasing. It means the gravitational is maximum, the gravitational force on planet Earth is maximum at poles, all right, not at equator. So first statement is absolutely wrong, so we can cut it off. Second, it is greater near the equator and less at the poles, or totally opposite. Just mentioned you, the equator has the less gravitational force activity and poles have the higher gravitational force, all right. So it is opposite statement, so second statement is also wrong. Gravitational force of moon is greater than the earth. It is absolutely wrong. We all know that. So the answer is C, 1, 2 and 3. All right, let's go further. Consider the following statement about the earth's quake body waves. All right. First statement is S waves move faster than V, like P waves. P waves are similar to sound wave. P waves are called secondary waves. P waves can travel through all mediums and S waves travel only through solids only. Now here what we need to know that which statement is correct. S wave moves faster than P waves? No, not at all. Alright, S waves are the very secondary waves. It is the P wave which, when the earthquake, see, isko thoda samajhiye. Jab earthquake kahin se shake karta hai, kahin pe ek activity hota hai. So what happens? The point of incident releases a different kind of shock waves. So P wave, S wave and L wave. These three waves, P, S and L waves, they are three waves which releases when the incident of earthquake happened from that point of incident. Now S wave is the first wave which travels immediately to the different levels of earth and it reaches till surface. Alright, so S wave is faster than P waves. It is a secondary wave. It means it comes right after S, but it is almost similar to the S, but they are much faster. Alright, means P waves are much faster than S waves. So first statement is wrong. Second, P waves are similar to sound waves. No, they're not at all similar to sound waves. You need a very high vibration for sound. All right, they are not that vibrating waves. Obviously, they are waves. Sound waves are also sinusoidal. These waves are also sinusoidal, like baseline and this. All right, so they are also vibrating, but not that much so that they can produce a sound, or they almost very much different from the sound waves. All right, so frequency of the both waves is quite different, so we do not consider that. So second option is wrong. Third, P waves are secondary waves. No, S waves are secondary waves, right? First P waves release, second S wave release, then combined together they release L waves, that is love wave, which is destructible. S and P waves are not destructible. Fourth statement is correct, that P waves can travel through all mediums. They can travel through water, they can travel through land, they can travel through air. That is correct. S waves have very specified, they are choosy. They do not travel in every surface, or they do not travel in every medium. They only travel through solid. They do through solid. They do not travel in water, they do not travel in air, which has less density. All right, so accordingly the fourth statement is absolutely correct. All right, hazardous effect of earthquake includes soil liquefaction, fires, flood from dam and lever failure, tsunami, differential ground settlement, all of the above. We all know that, all of the above. All right, so when something is shaking, obviously the soil will fall suddenly out of the mountain. Fires can release, obviously the land can break, the inner lava can come out, which is also a common feature of earthquake. Floods, obviously dams can crack down and the flood can cause. Tsunami, if the earthquake happened at the bottom of the surface of your ocean, obviously the tsunami releases. Not all the time. It has a very specified condition to generate a tsunami, okay? So that's a different case. Next is differential ground settlement. Obviously, when the earthquake happens, it shakes. We know in Assam we have Chandubi Lake. All right, people say that that region was totally a mountainous after the significant history of earthquake have generated at that point of time, at that history of time. Sorry, so that lake has been generated by that action. All right, so the answer is all of the above, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. Next question is, consider the following statement about the earth crust. The first statement is, oceanic crust is thicker than the continental crust. Wow, let's see. Type of rock found in continental is of type basalt. Third is, mean density of oceanic crust is 3g1 cm2. Wow, it is a tough question, but nothing is tough, we can solve it. Now we have to find that which is incorrect option. So it means we have to find one correct, done. Our time will be done. So here what is happening is, first statement, that oceanic crust is thicker than continental crust, which is purely wrong. Continental crust are thicker than oceanic crust. But remember, maybe they are thick, but they are less dense. Oceanic crust are thin compared to the continental crust, but they are much denser and they are much harder, much stronger. It is not easy to break oceanic floor easily, all right? But the thickness, obviously continental crust has more, but the problem is the density is less, all right? So the first statement is incorrect, that's why. Type of rock found in a continental is a type of basalt. Obviously, when the lava comes out, they flows down, they settle down, they start solidifying and they start converting into basaltic, because lava is full of basalt. Alright, so the statement of second is correct. Mean density of oceanic crust is 3g1 centimeter square. No, it is less than that, or maybe more than that. Alright, this point you can see in... Yes, you can get it in NCERT, second फंडामेंटल फिजियोग्राफी बाय रिटन बाय द माजिद हुसैन सर, ओके, तो आप वहाँ से आप उसको देख सकते हो. सो आंसर इज सी, 1 and 3. ऑलराइट, लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट अबाउट द अर्थ इंटीरियर. अर्थ इंटीरियर, मेंटल कंटेन्स एस्टेनोस्फेयर विच इज अ सोर्स ऑफ मैग्मा फॉर वोल्केनोस. मेंटल हैज डेंसिटी लोअर देन द अर्थ क्रस्ट. कैसे पॉसिबल है यार, इट इज अ मॉल्टन थिंग. मॉल्टन थिंग कैन नॉट बी डेंसर देन द सॉलिड. ऑलराइट, सो सेकेंड स्टेटमेंट इज रॉन्ग. थर्ड, इनर कोर इज इन लिक्विड स्टेट. नो, इनर कोर इज अ सॉलिड स्टेट, दैट इंटीरियर कोर. आउटर कोर इज अ लिक्विड स्टेट. फोर्थ, कोर इज मेड अप ऑफ मेटल्स लाइक एल्यूमिनियम एंड सिलिकॉन. नो नो नो, योर कोर इज प्योरली फॉर्म्ड ऑफ आयरन, आयरन, आयरन. ऑल राइट, एंड इनसाइड दैट सॉलिड इंटीरियर कोर, दैट बेसिक कोर ऑफ अर्थ, देर इज अ कंटिन्यूस रिएक्शन प्रोसेस गोइंग ऑन. एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइंटिस्ट, मैनी साइंटिस्ट बिलीव दैट कोर इंटीरियर पार्ट इज कंसिस्ट विद हैवी रेडियो एक्टिव मटीरियल्स. दोज हु आर कीप रिएक्टिंग एवरी टाइम, एंड दैट्स वाई दे आर ऑलवेज रिलीजिंग ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी एंड हीट विच मेल्ट सराउंडिंग मेटल्स और द मटीरियल्स. यू मस्ट बी वंडर्ड दैट एवरीथिंग इन साइड द अर्थ इज इन अ मोल्टन स्टेज, वाई द कोर ऑफ अर्थ इज इन अ सॉलिड स्टेज. बिकॉज यू प्लीज रिमेंबर, ये जानने के लिए हमसे बिल्कुल मिलिए, क्योंकि इट हैज़ अ वेरी गुड कॉन्सेप्ट रिगार्डिंग दैट वाई द कोर इज वेरी सॉलिड. द कोर इज सॉलिड इज नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ लाइक टेम्परेचर, में टेम्परेचर की वजह से नहीं है. इट इज सॉलिड बिकॉज ऑफ ह्यूज एक्सट्रीम लेवल ऑफ टेम्परेचर, मीन्स प्रेशर. ऑलराइट, ऑब्वियसली द कोर वॉन्ट्स टू गेट मेल्ट, बट देर इज नो नॉट इनफ स्पेस बिकॉज द अर्थ इंटीरियर पार्ट इज टोटली रेजिस्टिंग इट. And there is no space to get melt, because when the solid material is melting, means it requires more area, more space, and there is no space. All right. So the answer should be the one. Next question, please. That is, consider the following statement about the volcanoes. Okay, shield volcanoes are very steep. They are characterized by the high explosivity. Remember, आपको पहले भी आपने कई बार पढ़ा सुना होगा. अगर आपको UPSC prelims clear करना है, NCERT कम से कम 4 से 5 बार रिवीजन होना चाहिए आपका. जी सी लियोंग को अच्छे से पढ़िए, बेसिक फंडामेंटल पढ़िए. ऑल राइट, अब जी सी लियोंग में आपको इसका पहले का वाला जवाब मिल जाएगा. सेकेंड, कंपोजिट वॉल्केनोज आर ऑफन नॉन एक्सप्लोसिव. कॉल्डेरा वॉल्केनोज आर एक्सप्लोसिव एंड अनयूजुअली फॉर्म्स कोलैप्स्ड डिप्रेशन. फ्लड बसाल्ट्स हैव लो फ्लूडिटी. फ्लड बसाल्ट्स have low fluidity. All right, here we need to understand. Fourth statement is definitely wrong, because these flood basalts are basically basic lava. And basic lava, what it does, they have high fluidity. When they have high fluidity, so they travel like faster than acidic lava. You can all can see, I will give you the reference, G.C. Leong, maybe 3rd chapter or 4th chapter, you will get the volcanism and earthquake. You can get this information from there very easily. Here I am responding, don't worry. But if you have any doubt, you can see and watch there. Okay, see there. You can confirm it there. Next, composite volcanoes are often non-explosive. Okay, no, it's not like that. They do explode. Because composite volcanoes, they contains for so many years, and out of a sudden they suddenly blast. All right. So when this out of a sudden happen, they actually literally explode. All right. So it is not non-explosive, it is explosive. Shield volcanoes are very steep. No, they are like very gentle, having a very gentle slope, and they are kind of shield in between the two landforms maybe, or the between the two islands maybe. All right. So, third is correct and everything is wrong. So third will be the pure answer. Consider the following statements about earthquakes. Earthquake focus in mid-oceanic ridges are deep. Earthquake focus in alpine Himalaya and rim of Pacific are shallow. Stromboli volcano is called the lighthouse of Mediterranean. All right. Here I have included the world geography also. Here we have to find the third option. Like third option is correct, that is D. It is purely factual. Okay, Stromboli is in the volcano is called the lighthouse of Mediterranean. All right. It is very close to that Italy region. Earthquake focus in Alpine Himalaya and rim of Pacific are shallow. No, they are very much like steep. They are very much deep. बहुत deep है वो. Shallow और deep के बीच में आपको याद रखना है. They have mentioned shallow. You have to think it is deep. Earthquake focus in mid-oceanic ridges are deep. Mid-oceanic ridges cannot be deep. Ridges means what? Ridges means the mountain of inside the ocean. Mountains inside the ocean. So the water will be shallow, na? They are not deep. They are not at all deep. Like you can go and check in your 35th school atlas of Oxford. In that world geography, in that world picture, you will see the Pacific and Atlantic ridges. There you will see a very light color of blue, which means the water is shallow. It is not deep. All right. So the first statement and second statement are wrong. So the third statement is correct. Consider the following statement with reference to the ocean floor spreading. Okay. It is related to the plate tectonic activity. The first statement is rocks equidistant from the either side of mid-oceanic ridges, remarkable difference in information, chemical composition. Rocks closer to the mid-oceanic ridges are oldest and have normal polarity. Third, according to the Hess, spreading of one ocean does not cause the shrinking of other. No, what is he saying? No. Earth cannot expand and it has a limited area, which means if the ocean is spreading somewhere, it is like contracting. If it is not contracting, means the area of Earth is increasing. So it is not possible. So that third statement is absolutely like not correct, incorrect. Second is rocks closer to the mid-oceanic ridges are oldest and have normal polarity, which is again very much true. Like when you see the mid-oceanic ridges, the far you will go, the bottom at the ridges you will go, you will get the oldest, and the polarity will be normal according to the magnetic field of the Earth. All right, we can understood it from the paleomagnetism concept, which is quite easy. All right, you can get that topic from the Majid Hussain also. That is the reference point of view. Rocks equidistant from either side of the mid-oceanic ridges? No, not at all. It is not necessarily important. It is not necessarily can happen. Obviously, the distance of between the two rocks on the both side of the mountains can be different. All right. So the second option is absolutely correct. Next is, consider the following statement about volcanic landforms. Locoliths, again go for GC Long. Again, I am saying people, zara dekhiye usme jaake. Lacoliths are small magmatic material that cools in deeper depth of the crust. Batholiths are large dome shaped, dintrusive bodies with a level base of connected by the pipe like conduit on below. From below, lava rested in saucer concave to the sky body. It is called lapolith. Near horizontal bodies of intrusive igneous rocks are called tubes. My blowing question. Please GC Leong ko padhiye. All right. Agar aap logon ne achhe se padha hai, you guys can give the answer of it. It's a very simple accordingly. So the first thing is absolutely wrong, which is lacolith is continuously connected with the very bottom level of lava deposition or the lava supply. Batholith is a large dome shaped. No, they are not dome shaped. Actually, lacoliths are dome shaped. All right, you will have a picture in their GC Leong. Aap wahan pe jaake dekh sakte hain. So aise hi aapka second option galat ho jata hai. Lava rested as saucer concave. Yeah, this is true. A very steep horizontal type structure you will see in your map, in your diagram. Okay, they are flattened, the lava deposits, ye sab hota hai usme. Near horizontal bodies of the intrusive igneous rocks are called dikes. No, they are vertical bodies, they are not horizontal. Absolutely wrong. The fourth is wrong, second is wrong, so that first is wrong. The answer is C, that is third. Consider the following statement, that Wagner's continental drift theory. Penthalsa was a supercontinent and Pangaea was a rock. No, absolutely wrong. Actually, supercontinent was Pangaea and super ocean was Penthalsa, right? So option one is incorrect. Second, force behind drifting of continents is conventional current due to radioactive elements, right? Which is also incorrect. That is not radioactive element. It is the kinetic force and the angular momentum they get when they collide with the asthenosphere, the lower mantle, all right? And when they collide with the lithosphere, they get a convectional movement from one place to another. Actually, it is a convectional movement. It is not conventional movement, all right? There was an evidence of jigsaw fit of continent which support Wagner's continental drift theory. Definitely, if you, आज भी मैं आपको बोलता हूँ, if you see your map, if you know how to draw the map, world map, if you place, if you pick Africa from one place and put it in that corner part of South America, it will adjust. All right, it is like a puzzle game. So the world, obviously, it was a kind of considered as a kind of evidence which Wagner, Alfred Wagner, said about the continental drift theory, because he was so obsessed with to let the world know that how the continents are keep changing and they are different thing, they are moving from one place to another. All right. So second question is, consider the following statement on the plate tectonics. The plate tectonic is a massive slab of solid rocks composed of continental lithosphere only. Plates are static over the asthenosphere as rigid in uniform. No, second is absolutely wrong. There are five major plates recognized as of now. No, there are more than that, more than 9, more than 10, right? Aise gin ke kara sakte hain. Let me give you the example. First, Eurasian plate. Second, North American plate. Third, Antarctic plate. Fourth, African plate. Fifth, South American plate. Sixth, five to aise hi ho gaye. Sixth, Indian plate, all right? Seventh, Pacific plate, and your... Done. Seven to eight major plates we have. All right. Minor plates we have several, like Cacao's plate, Burmese plate, Philippine plate, Taiwan plate, Australian plate as a major plate. Right. So 8, 9. So the third option is incorrect. So that should be the answer. Second option is also incorrect, which is plates always move. They do not. Asthenosphere is a kind of like what? A moving boat over the water. Right. That asthenosphere is a liquid, a semi-liquid material, and the lithosphere, which is solid, is literally traveling or the moving over the asthenosphere's body, all right, surface. So second option is incorrect. First option is also incorrect. It is not a massive slab of solid rock. It is a part of lithosphere, but it is not only a slab of solid rock. It is composed of various things, all right. So first is also wrong. So the answer should be 1, 2 and 3. Let's see the next cacao specific plate between Central America and Pacific plate. What do you think, guys? Just imagine. Fight padabat. Time nahi hai. UPSC hai bhai. Nazca plate between South America and Pacific plate. Caroline plate which is between Philippine and Indian plate. What do you think? आपको यहाँ पे कौन सा करेक्ट है बताना है. एक्चुअली मैं आपको बताऊँ, cacao plate मैं आपको डायग्राम बना के दिखा था, बट देर इज़ अ टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट. आई विल जस्ट गिव यू द रेफरेंस. आप अपना एटलस खोलिए जहाँ पे आपका प्लेट टेक्टोनिक की प्लेट्स दिखाई गई हैं. अगर आपके पास 35th एडिशन ऑफ ऑक्सफोर्ड स्कूल एटलस है, गो टू दैट पेज. वहाँ पे आपको प्लेट टेक्टोनिक का पेपर दिया होगा, पेज दिया होगा, उसमें आप अच्छे से देखिए. वहाँ पे माइनर प्लेट्स एंड मेजर प्लेट्स दोनों दी गई हैं, उसको ज़रा ध्यान से देखिए. cacao प्लेट इज एक्चुअली आपका जो ये पैसिफिक प्लेट है और आपका जो अमेरिकन प्लेट है, यानी नॉर्थ सेंट्रल अमेरिकन प्लेट है, उसके बीच में आता है. सो विच इज़ करेंट. और यहाँ पे कौन है आपका? कैलिफोर्निया वाला रीजन ऑफ यूएसए. ऑलराइट, तो जाके मैप में देखना. कैलिफोर्निया रीजन इज 1905 में एक बहुत ही खतरनाक भूकंप आया था, एंड द टेक्टोनिक मूवमेंट विच इज हैविंग दिस प्लेस इज ट्रांसफॉर्म प्लेट टेक्टोनिक. ओके, they are not like your divergent plate tectonic or convergent plate tectonic nahi hai. They are what? Transforming tectonic plates hain. All right, Nazca plate, it is obviously in the South American side and Pacific side, at the western corner of South America. Okay, वहाँ आपको मिल जाएगा Nazca plate. Coronal plate, obviously आपको ये Indian plate और Philippines के बीच में मिल जाएगा, that South China Sea वाला area, वहाँ पे आपको मिल जाएगा. So all of the options are correct, 1, 2, and 3. Next, consider the following statement about the ocean floor configuration. Okay, configuration के बारे में हमें बताना है, ये तो बहुत simple है. Let's see. Continental margins are transition between continent shore and deep ocean basin. Okay, a basal plain lie between the continent margins and mid-oceanic ridges. Mid-oceanic ridges interconnected chain of mountain system with the ocean. Abyssal plains are a zone of intense volcanic activity. All right. Which of the following statement is incorrect? Actually, sabhi incorrect hai. Continental margin transition zone nahi hota hai continental shore aur deep ocean basin ka. Continental margin transition zone hota hai do plate ke beech mein, bhai. Are you getting my point? To wo different hai. Second, abyssal plain lie between continental margin and mid-oceanic ridges. Kaise possible hai? No. It is in the middle part. Mid-oceanic ridges interconnected chain of the mountain system of the with the ocean. With the ocean. So, no. No, it is purely incorrect. Mid-oceanic ridges actually, ye kya hai? They are the chain of the mountain. Definitely they are the chain of the mountain. Alright. Ye with the ocean nahi, inside the ocean hota hai. Just see the quality of answer, like statement. Everybody will get confused. Inside the ocean hota hai, with the ocean nahi hai. Okay? With the ocean lagate hi aapka jawab bilkul alag ho jata hai, aur inside the ocean lagate hi aapka jawab bilkul different hota hai. Just remember that. So third is incorrect. Inside the ocean hota to correct hota. Abyssal plain are the zones of intense volcanic activity. Definitely वहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा volcanic activity होती है. तो fourth statement तो correct है, right? So C option is correct. That is 1, 2, and 3, which is incorrect. The answer is incorrect. All right. So with this, thank you people, thank you guys. I hope आप लोगों को ये questions अच्छे लगे हों. आप इनको practice करिए. इसी तरह के अलग अलग लेवल पे सेक्शनल क्वेश्चंस आपको और फुल इंटीग्रेटेड क्वेश्चंस आपको मिलते रहेंगे और इस मॉक टेस्ट में मिलेंगे. आई होप टू सी यू गाइस फर्दर एंड डिस्कसिंग ऑन दीज इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक्स ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, एंड दे आर वेरी मच हाई स्कोरिंग पार्ट. ऑल यू नीड इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ब्रेन. ओके, सो टिल